plastic waste is all around us. There's plastics in almost everything you can think of, from automobiles all the way to fabrics and materials. We continue to use petroleum resources to make new plastics. We use those plastics, and then they either end up discarded into the landfill or they leak into the environment. Recycling is one way that we can give a second life to waste plastics. So our goal in this lab is actually to take these materials and reconstruct them at a chemical level. Our lab broadly works towards making chemicals that we need from things like plastic waste, which we have a lot of and could be a great thing to convert into chemicals that we need. So in here, I've got a polyethylene film, a little plastic cap that has some blue dye in it.
I've also got these two Barbie shoes. I'm using them for characterization.
Plastic is a polymer. This means it's many units, polymer. So if you actually think about the molecular structure, it's a big chain of atoms. And that gives it the strength and durability for all sorts of products that we know and love. But they're just really hard to break down. So one of the things that we work on is what we call chemical recycling. The mass spec will tell you what the product is, and then they're clicking through each peak and looking at what the molecule is. If we can turn the plastic into the molecule that it started with, it could be used to make new plastic, and that new plastic would have the same quality as the original plastic material. We have to come up with strategies to be able to figure out how we can actually break down these complex mixtures of plastics into something more pure like this. A catalytic process that could take a mixture of different contaminated plastic waste and be able to convert it into chemicals that we need, that are useful and high value, but with low energy, with more inexpensive catalysts. And all of these things add up to ultimately make the process more economically and environmentally viable. If we can develop a process for plastic recycling that pays for itself, maybe we could see these implemented at an industrial scale and actually start to make a dent in the plastic waste problem that we have.